In this video, we're going to look at solubility of common ions in water. While doing so, we'll construct the solubility table together and classify a few substances as soluble or insoluble in water. Before we dive into the solubility table, let's first make sure we know what solubility is. It's a chemical property that measures the ability of a specific substance to dissolve in a solvent. In short, it tells you how much something can dissolve in a solvent. The substance here can be solid, liquid, or gas, and the same goes for the solvent. Note that solubility is dependent on temperature, pressure, properties of the solute and the solvent. That's why, sometimes when given the solubility of a substance, you'll see it expressed in grams of that substance in a specific amount of the solvent. For example, 100 ml at a specific temperature like 25 degrees Celsius. That means, at 25 degrees Celsius, in 100 ml of water, maximum amount of Na3PO4 that can dissolve is 14.5 grams. Now that we're clear what solubility is, let's construct our solubility table. Chlorates, acetates, ammoniums, alkali metals, and nitrates, the CAN, can. Any substance with these ions can dissolve in water, making them soluble. There are no exceptions. That means, substances like BaClO3, LiOH, CaNO32, they are all soluble in water. Next are the halogens. Generally, anything with halogens will be soluble, except for when combined with small, medium, large metals, SML. That's an easy way to remember silver, mercury, and lead. That means BaCl2, for example, will be soluble. However, mercury bromide, Hg2Br2, will be insoluble because mercury is part of the exception. Moving on to the sulfates, there are some exceptions as well. Sulfates with barium, strontium, or lead will be insoluble. Calcium and silver sulfates will be slightly soluble. Let's take SrSO4 for example. It's going to be insoluble since Sr is part of the exception. BeSO4 for example, it's going to be soluble because it's not part of the exception. Moving on to the carbonates, phosphates, and sulfites. Any substances with these anions are insoluble, except for when they are paired with ammonium and group 1A metals. Let's take SrCO3 for example. It's a carbonate with Sr, strontium metal. Since it's not part of the exceptions, that means SrCO3 is insoluble. Na2S, since it contains sulfite anion, which is generally insoluble, but because it's paired with Na, which is an alkali metal, that makes it soluble. Last but not least, the hydroxides. Generally, hydroxides are insoluble, except for when they are paired with barium, strontium, ammonium, and group 1A metals. For example, lithium hydroxide is soluble, while calcium hydroxide is not. Now that we're done constructing our solubility table or solubility rules, are you ready to take it for a spin? The best way to learn is to give it a try. So why don't we try classifying a few substances as soluble or insoluble? Our first example is silver chlorate, AgClO3. First thing we have to do is look at its anion, chlorate, ClO3. Since all chlorates are soluble and there's no exception, that means AgClO3 is soluble, making it an aqueous. Let's move on to the second example, barium sulfate, BaSO4. The anion is sulfate, SO4-. If we look at sulfates, all sulfates are soluble, except for Ba2+, Sr2+, and Pb2+. Since our question has barium in it, that makes it insoluble. Therefore, in water, barium sulfate will form precipitate, which means we'll write the physical state as solid. Our third and final example, Li2CO3. CO3 is carbonate, it's generally insoluble, except for when it's paired with ammoniums and alkali metals. Since our example has Li in it, that makes it soluble. Therefore, when water is added to LiCO3, it becomes an aqueous solution. Want to try out more on your own? Well, here are 9 substances for you to classify. I'll place the answers in the description box. I hope the video helped increase your understanding on solubility. Do subscribe and thanks for watching.